Now in RTE1, Craig's been the cause of wounds he can't easily heal as Sarah struggles to deal with the truth in Shortland Street.
And just for the record, I never meant to hurt you.
Hard to believe when the man you live with ups and goes elsewhere without a word of warning.
I am. I'm really sorry.
What are you doing here? Surprising Craig? Where is he?
Oh, we both knew that it wasn't finished between us. I never gave us the chance to end things properly. Clear the air, you know. Sarah.
I've been here all night, lying awake, waiting for you. Where have you been?
Come on, tell me.
What are you doing here,
mate? You bastard! You've been with Ellie!
Just settle down! Come on, Sarah! No! Come on! Just calm down!
Hey, let her go!
Get out of here!
What's going on?
We can sort this.
I think you should go. You better talk to Giv.
I'm not going anywhere.
Get out!
You heard her, mate. You're not doing any good here.
Scarly going to school in Europe?
I might not get it. There's five of us being interviewed, including Etty.
Nice guy, but...
I know, I kind of said that. Now he's not speaking to me.
Well, that's what competition does, babe. Sorts the winners from the losers.
I'm still nervous.
You'll be right. And out of here. Craig will miss you.
He's got the pod scrubber, remember?
Scarlet. What happened to that sweet little kid I used to know?
Life. But me and Sarah, we're not so bad these days. In fact, I might even invite her to Dad's birthday dinner.
When's that?
Today. Dad gets back from Rotorua tonight. I'm going to make him something, bake a cake. I want to get something else, but I'm going to need your help.
So, post text twice and a...
Give Juno. Thanks.
Have I really changed that much, Chris?
Melanie, what are you doing here?
Shopping, of course. My hobbies haven't changed, even if I have.
Oh, no, you look great. So, are you still in Wanaka, or...?
Yes, very boring of me, but I can't stay away from the place.
Well, that's scenery, eh?
Oh, freezing cold winters.
Yeah, so up here for a bit of sunshine and shopping.
Honey, do you want me to order?
Oh, no, I was just catching up with an old,
wife, the first model. I'm Melanie Kirk.
Tony Warner.
Great to meet you. Look, I was just about to order breakfast. You guys will join me, won't you?
Sure, okay.
What can I get you?
I'll have what you're having, Chris.
There'll be a Q&A at the end. Have a nice day.
Thank you.
I need to get the show on the road. Where's Craig?
Oh, I thought you sent TK to get him.
It was ages ago. I knew this would happen as soon as Sarah turned up.
Sarah's here?
Yeah, she arrived last night. No reservations, of course. I had to let her into Craig's room, otherwise she would have barged in on you two. And then his presentation wouldn't have got fixed.
I wish you'd told me.
Oh, it's all right. He's here now. What happened to you?
Running with a coat hanger.
And then you jumped into yesterday's clothes. Did you not hear your wake-up call? Did you spend all night in the spa with Sarah?
Is it time to start?
Yeah.
Better wish me luck. I think I might need it. Thanks, Karen.
It's been a wild night. I knew Sarah was a strippy cow, but I had no idea she was into rough sex.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you take your places, please.
Shower. Are you looking for something?
When I get dressed.
Then what?
Yeah. Home.
I'll take you. I'll wait outside.
No, it's okay.
The last time I heard from you was when Mum died.
You didn't mind me sending flowers, did you?
Of course not.
I really like Margot, although I suspect she was glad to see the back of me.
She could never figure you out, that's all.
I heard from someone that you'd had a child. Is that right?
Harry, he's 4.
Same age as my boy.
Really? I didn't know.
Second marriage. Big mistake, except for Ben. I don't know what I'd do without him.
But he's not here with you?
Typical male. I mentioned shopping in a motel, and he's packing his bags to start Nana Mary's.
How's your mum?
Going strong as ever. She's very impressed by you.
Me?
Yep, she read about the golfer with spinal injuries and the woman with facial paralysis.
I didn't think the paralysis case had made the papers.
I get all the medical journals delivered to my practice. Mum just can't keep her hands off them.
Oh, she's a doctor too?
I thought she was an English teacher.
Yes, and she always thought that I let the good one get away. Now she's convinced of that.
In spite of the appalling statistics and the medical community's increased awareness of these hidden costs, excessive alcohol consumption remains the most pressing issue facing teenagers in New Zealand today. Thank you. I'm sorry, I won't be taking any questions this morning. If you want to contact me about anything at all, you can see our PA, Libby Jeffries. She will give you my email address. Thank you.
What? No Q&A. What is going on and where is TK?
You can't just refuse to answer questions.
I need to see Sue.
You need to fulfil your commitments.
Yeah, that's exactly what I'm trying to do.
I mean, professionally, these are your peers. You owe them some respect.
I don't believe this. TK's halfway back to Ferndale.
What?
With Sarah. He's driving her car. Will someone please tell me what's going on?
Libby, business cards.
Of course.
Now, I'm going upstairs, I'm packing and I'm leaving.
No, you're not.
I have to see you, Huia.
You walk now and you'll spend the drive back to Ferndale planning your next career move.
What?
This is an international conference and you're scheduled to run a speciality seminar after lunch. If you renege on that, I will be seeking your resignation. I mean it, Craig.
Don't you think it's weird? Melanie turning up at Sugar out of the blue?
Well, if she's staying at a hotel nearby...
But why stay at a hotel near here? Why not a leafier part of town? She's a doctor, she can afford it.
Well, maybe she likes it around here.
Maybe she was looking for you.
I don't think so, hon.
Chris, she chose a coffee shop 2 seconds from where you work. She knows all about your career and she didn't look a bit surprised to see you. If that was my ex-husband, I reckon you'd be pretty suspicious.
About what?
I think she wants something.
Like?
She's divorced. She still looks great. She's conveniently child-free, and she couldn't stop drooling over you.
So, you think she wants my body?
Stranger things have happened. Seriously, though, look at all those Find Your High School Sweetheart websites. They're the cause of more divorces.
Darling, come on. It was a chance meeting. I probably won't see Mel again for another 10 years.
Bet you do.